Hey, what's up, everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and welcome to another Onshape Quick Tip, where today we're going to talk about mask properties and assigning materials to our models. So here we can see we're looking at Onshape, and in the lower right corner down here, we've got this icon for mask properties. And when we click on that icon, Onshape says, which part do you wish to measure? I'll just click this part from the graphics area. And Onshape gives me some feedback, including the volume, the surface area, and the center of mass for this model. But you'll notice that some of this information is missing, specifically the feedback regarding the mass of this part. And that's because I haven't assigned a material to this model yet. So I'm going to close this window for mass properties, and I'm going to look over here on the left. Now there's a splitter bar here where we can split between the parts that are in our part studio and the features that are in our parts. And so we're going to go down here to the lower part below all the features. We've got the parts that are in our part studio, and we're going to do a right mouse button and choose assign material. This takes us to the available library of materials from the Onshape material library. I can go into this menu and scroll down through, or I could type in, like I'll type in steel here, and let's see what types of steel do we have here. I'll just go with a carbon steel for this model, and I'll hit the green check mark. Now that material has been assigned, and now I can go back down to mass properties, click on this part to measure, and we can see that now we've got information like our center of mass, and we've got the overall mass of this part. Now, I happen to know that the mass of this part is supposed to be 311 grams, and instead it's coming up at 313. And that's because the carbon steel that I'm using has a slightly lower density than the carbon steel in the Onshape library. So what I could do is right mouse button, go to edit material, and then I could come over here to where it says custom, and I could input my own custom name. So I'll call this one Toby Carbon Steel. And then I can input a custom density, 0.0078, for my custom density for this material. Now, when I hit the green check mark and I go back down here to the corner to my mass properties, I can see that the mass properties for this part is coming up with the correct mass of 311 grams. Now, that's something that works really good when you're just doing it once in a while, but if I'm gonna be using that material over and over and over again, I'm gonna wanna create a custom material and a custom material library, but I'll save that tip for another video. But I think that's a good place to stop for this video, because those two topics, where to find the mass properties, which again is down here in the lower right corner, and where to assign my own material, which is a right mouse button here on this part in the part studio and edit material, those were things that I found to be a little confusing as a SolidWorks user moving to Onshape. But what do you think? Did you find that confusing? Did you already know about that functionality? Let me know down in the comments below. And of course, if you're enjoying this series, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to come back for the next episode.